So you guys are gonna have to let me know how things look. If anything should be adjusted, if I should move a camera. You know, this is all for fun, whatever. That's the great part.
Add the image to the tweet.
Add the image to the tweet? I could have, but I retweeted Blue Apron, so it doesn't matter. I'm gonna lower this a little bit. All right. So, I figured I'd try Blue Apron just for the hell of it. Some parts of it confuse me.
Luke, I am your father.
Every week they send you under the plan that I'm under, which is a two-person plan. They send you three different dishes. Each dish obviously feeds two people. You can get four people, so on and so forth. But they send you three dishes out of a week of, you know, basically it won't last you the week. So I'm a little confused on that, but it would be nice a meal every day, but it's not that type of delivery service, I guess. I guess in a way what you could do is split it up and get the family plan, the four or whatever it is. But yeah, it's kind of disappointing. But first things first, I wanted to see how they send it, how they ship it, and all that stuff to see if it's any good, really. If it's good, then maybe I'll keep up my membership past this month, because I'm going to give it a full month. I'm going to give it a full month and see how it is. No low carb options. Okay, I haven't looked at that. If I start working out and start doing my thing, exercising, I guess that could be a problem, I suppose.
Looks good on the picture.
Yeah, it looks good in the picture. But what's gonna come out of the pan is gonna be absolutely horrendous after I get done with this. I figured I'd start with the fish.
Just a full-fledged meal.
It's a full-fledged meal as far as I know. Why is this crap on here? So, this is the spicy Ponzu-glazed Catfish. It comes with also zucchini, garlic rice, and ginger peanuts. They give you a little bag of peanuts. Who cares about that? So, here's the little bag of rice that they give you. All right. So on this side here, they're gonna show all the ingredients. Again, if you type recipe, exclamation point recipe, you'll get a link to the image of this that I'm looking at. So, yes, the roof will be on fire when I'm done, or partway through cooking this. So yeah, ingredients, two catfish, fillets, three-quarter cup white basmati rice, three cloves of garlic, which, again, they give you the garlic, so a full head. Two scallions, which are in there, so let's go grab that. Actually, if somebody can type in...
Is this really a good idea, though?
Is this really a good idea? Well, you don't live here, so you'll still have a house after this, so I guess there's that. Cam 2 and Cam 2 again. Wow, okay. Cam 2. There we go. So now, it's not working. That's great. Somebody type Cam 2. Is that not working or what? Is that not moving?
Camera one. Camera two.
Okay. Cam two. Oh, good. It didn't move. It just took a while. So now you can see what's in the fridge. See? Pretty cool. Anyway, so what I did was everything they shipped me, I kind of threw it into a little tin. And each one you get, You get three bags for each meal, right? I'll just close. Well, you know what? Let's take this out too. So, the two meals that they sent are the catfish and the chicken.
Look at that.
So here's a chicken fillet. So I'll put that away. So there you go. So what they did was they sent three bags, right? One for each meal. This says the Ponzu-glazed Catfish knickknacks. So all the bullshit you need is in here. Then this is the chicken and biscuit knickknacks, which we don't need. And the basil fettuccine knickknacks, which again, we don't need. Now in this ingredients thing, they don't list carrots. So under the other meal that they sent carrots. I could also do this. But here's the two zucchini, I think, right? Yes, one zucchini. So they only require one. You know what? We're gonna do a smaller one. And here's the scallions. And they send you a collard greens in a nice big bag. So, and then the fettuccine, they put in this little thing. I don't know if you guys can see it too well. I'll hold it up to this camera. It's just a fucking, you know, little plastic thing with an appropriate portion for two people, apparently. Two American people? I don't know.
Where is the bacon?
Sad face. Here's the bacon. So, what do we got? Do tell if this microphone starts cutting out. Oh, the zucchini. I'm gonna put that back as well. All right, so. What? Oh, Jesus. That sounded weird. Okay, so there you go. Got the catfish, got the bacon, because I always add bacon. No, they didn't send that. The rice, and then we got the knickknacks bag. This is one thing I definitely wanted to check out before and see what's in it. So let's take it out. Sure. Three bottles of stuff. So we got black and white sesame seeds, because everybody likes sesame seeds, right? Here's the peanuts. You know, United Airlines sized, when you fly, you get a little bag of peanuts. Ginger. Did they say they want ginger? Yes, they have one inch piece of ginger. Looks like there's two. So, there's two of them in there. If you guys can see that too well. Let me know if a lot of this stuff is not coming up on the camera too well. So, peanuts, ginger, black and white sesame seeds. We got ponzu sauce. It says it contains soy. Sure what that smells like. Sesame oil. Oh, all right. Sure. And sambal oilic. What the fuck does that mean? I have no idea. I should probably not curse. What do you think? So this smells like salsa. It's like a tomato something or other. If somebody wants to look up what the hell that is, S-A-M-B-A-L-O-E-L-E-K. kind of interesting what's what that's made up of. So, knickknacks: 3 tablespoons of peanuts, 2 tablespoons of ponzu sauce, 2 teaspoons of black and white sesame seeds, which I may or may not put on there. I'll probably put it on there because they say to put it on there. 1 1-inch piece of ginger. Again, we got that there. 1 tablespoon of sambal ulek. I guess I'm saying that right. 1 tablespoon of sesame oil.
Not gonna lie.
Not gonna lie.
Didn't expect and, a cooking stream.
You didn't expect a cooking stream. But we did. We've done some before. I could have sworn you've been around when we've done a few. So yeah, 275.
Sambal hot sauce typically made from a mixture of a variety of chili peppers with secondary ingredients such as shrimp paste, fish sauce, garlic, ginger, shallot, scallion, palm sugar, lime juice, and rice vinegar or other vinegars. I was.
Hot sauce. Okay.
Just didn't expect it.
Expect more. This is originally why I purchased these cameras, these little PTZ cameras, so you can do that. By the way, if somebody can say cam 2 one time, just once, one person, John will probably say it. I'll redirect that back camera down to the stove. So yeah, I do plan on doing more of these. It would be kind of fun to do more of these, especially with Blue Apron. Why the hell not, right? I got 2 more meals to cook, so I might as well keep doing it. All right. So, thank you. I can actually hear it turn behind me. As a glaze for nice catfish, harnessing the complex.
John.
John.
Yeah, John's slacking. What's he doing?
You're slipping.
You're slipping.
Our sides of garlic infused rice and summer zucchini sauteed with sesame oil and tossed with crunchy sesame seeds round out this exciting East Asian inspired dish. All right, yeah, sure. So on the bottom, again, if you type exclamation point recipe, if you type exclamation point recipe or Blue Apron, it'll give you what I'm looking at right here, the direct JPEG of it. I scanned it in. If you want to look at it. All right, so I guess we'll prepare the ingredients and make the glaze. Let's start with number one. Let's, you know, they say anybody can do this, so let's follow the steps. Wash and dry the fresh produce. So I guess we gotta start with that, huh? I could start with my hands as well. Might as well start cleaning that. Sure, soap kind of helps, huh? I should have opened the package before I did that. Oh well. Don't worry, I'll pick my nose plenty while I make this. So if you guys watch the No Man's Sky leaked trailer on YouTube, that's been taken down so many freaking times already. They keep trying to shut it down, but it comes right back up. All right. So I probably want to clean with cold water, not hot water, because that just wouldn't make sense. Thank you for saying recipe. All right. So let's open this shit. I did see it. All right.
Oh yes. Oh, yes. Game actually is, game what, it actually promised, is what it was to my promised. Surprise.
To my surprise.
And No Man's Sky will rock.
And No Man's Sky will rock.
Well, from what I've seen, I'm not too. I'm not too thrilled with what I see. I'll be perfectly honest with you. Not blown away. But then again, this is only the first planet. This is only the first thing. And it could be very tutorial-like. So maybe that's part of it. All right, so there's two fish here. I am gonna make both of them because why not? Apparently you can't just peel it off. It just tears right open. Do I have anything to put this on? You know what? I do. A freaking plate.
Mail a fish to me when it is done.
Yeah. I should, actually. All right. So let's wash. They say to wash both of them. So, let's do that.
Link. Error, you need to enter a camera number to toggle the view. 1 equals counter, 2 equals show.
So unfortunately, I don't have a camera over the sink, but then again, I don't think I really need one, so. One down. And I'll pat it down just to kind of get all the mortar off of it, right? I guess this will be the right way. It'd be nice if chefs at Blue Apron would be watching and tell me how badly I'm screwing this up. There you go. So that's taken care of. Now, they say peel and mince the garlic. Alright, so... let's push this to the side. This makes a damn mess. So you slam your hand down on the garlic, and it kind of splits open. I don't know if any of you ever played with garlic, but I'm sure there's an easier way of doing it too. Whoop, there it goes. One down. These garlic cloves. Now there is a trick to doing this, and I don't know it. There is a better way of getting your garlic, and I forgot how. Probably should have watch the YouTube video before going at the garlic this time, because I totally forgot. There is a trick I do know, and I may do it, but I don't know. We'll see. Just getting the excess shavings and shit out of here. Oh, oh, don't go anywhere. Right. These things have freaking skins on them. All right. Oh, nope, there's more. Anyway, all right. So, each one has like a, has all this skin all over it. So to take it off, normally what I do is I get two bowls. two silver bowls and I clang this shit around to get all that stuff off. So they say to mince it. But typically what I do is I use this tool, which is this little garlic pusher router thingy extractor, and it properly does it. So I'm gonna do my little trick here. Where is it? Where is it? Microphone keeps sliding down. All right, there we go. So again, two silver bowls, and I'll see how well this works for me this time. It worked last time. Let's see if it works this time. Loudness warning, if you have headphones on, take them off. I have no idea if this thing is gonna pick this up. Sure. All right, put them all in there. And there we go. One, two, three. Four. All sticky as all hell.
Shake it, baby.
Shake it, baby.
Shake it. Get that. This one. What else is in there? There's tons of them in there.
Shake and bake.
Shake and bake.
It's just sticky as shit. Now, I don't know if you can see it as clearly on this one. This one definitely didn't peel as much. Nor did this one. This one really stuck together. Wow. There we go. That one. Here we go. And you can tell that's all the shell stuff. No more garlic in there. And they're perfectly peeled. And that's using two bowls, and you just clang them together like mad, and the skins just fall right the hell off. It's pretty cool. All right. So, need a Ziploc bag. This type of bag is not a Ziploc, but whatever. And just drop them in there. Now this said I needed a certain amount. We're gonna find out what that is in a second. Just figured I'd get this clean. So this says, peel and mince the ginger. Let's do that. So there's the ginger. I've never actually played with ginger. How does it want it minced? So it doesn't actually tell you in the instructions how to actually do it. So if you don't know how to play with it, You have to look it up. But well, it's time for that. Let's just get to town. I don't know if there's an easier way to peel it. Remember, kids, always cut towards your thumb.
Cute his finger off. Watch it live.
Watch it live.
That looks dangerous.
Oh, yeah, it's dangerous. All I'm basically doing is pushing the ginger forward, not necessarily the thumb. I'm not like, you know, gripping this where I'm pushing my thumb into the blade. But as long as you have a very sharp knife, you don't have to worry about, you know. Ow! I'm just kidding. Here, let's do. There we go.
Dude.
So there you go. There's one piece. Dude! Don't.
If I had to wait for my dinner made by you, I would be dead, Suji Kappa.
Hold on, let me peel this. Okay. What I should do is go grab a fucking peeler. I should go get a peeler. But I'm doing it the chef way. I gotta practice my my knife skills. This is indeed ginger. I have no idea how to use it.
You peel ginger with a spoon.
Peel ginger with a spoon? Really? I didn't know that.
A chef peels ginger with a spoon.
I didn't know that. Well, where were you, let's say, 3 or 4 minutes ago?
Right, it's too big.
No, yeah, of course it's too big. You always peel with a really big knife, so people don't fuck with you. When they say, hey, you're going too slow, you just raise the knife. You're eating pizza. That's a fucking lazy way. You know, I kind of wonder if Blue Apron has pizza recipes. I'm going to try this with a spoon next time. But just next time. Because I don't trust you. I think you're full of shit. What the hell is Blue Apron? It's a food delivery service. They
That's
send you. It's a food delivery service, and they send 3 meals a week, and it serves 2, or you can get a family one serves 4.
Well, that should,
well,
cost,
that should
a lot.
Cost a lot.
Yeah, it costs a hell of a lot. But it's one of the cheaper ones of the services out there that do it. So I wanted to try it and see how much stuff you actually get and see if it's worthwhile. Okay. Anyway.
Or get a credit card and go use Google.
What? So, there's ginger, I think. That was the longest peeling of ginger ever. All right, and it says cut the zucchini. Okay, I cut the zucchini. I've never cut a zucchini. How does it want the... How does it want to cut? Just... Alright, sounds good to me. Doesn't say how thick. It does say how thick. Half inch thick rounds. Alright.
Peel it like a potato skin.
Nope, it just says cut them into half inch slices. So that's exactly what I'm going to do. And it's rolling away.
Text to speech vest.
Yeah, it is. At least it alerts me of like what's being said. The only problem is I think it's the same application you use. And it's really out of date. It's out of date, and it doesn't support certain things properly. There we go. All right, so there's my half inch rounds. Can you guys see that on this camera? 1.6? Yeah, I think it's
610.
It's I have 0.17, so I have 0.17. All right, so there are my rounds. I'll just pile them like coins. Boop. All right, so we got the ginger, need to mince the garlic.
One more zucchini.
No, I don't think so.
Master Chef has green.
So it says cut off and discard the root ends of the scallions. Now this says mince the garlic, but you know what? Screw mincing garlic.
That ass.
We're grabbing.
That ass.
Grabbing this. Let's see. Yeah, let's just do it. So, I guess it means the whole garlic, because I don't think garlic goes in any of the other ones. Too much what? Too much interaction. That's true. Just cook the fucking meal, asshole.
He has a lot of shit just in the kitchen. So gee, you can zoom in one kappa. Alone asterisk.
Do another one. And who says I'm living alone, huh? Wait, you think I can afford being unemployed for over 2 years now?
Where's your wife?
Where's your wife?
He lives with his mommy.
Where's your wife? Put her on stream. Ah.
She's in the kitchen.
She's
kitchen. Well, that's a very appropriate place for it. Very appropriate. All right, next. The only problem with this setup right now is I can't hear the music. I think that's enough. I think that's enough garlic. Because it wants me to make garlic rice with it, I guess. I don't know if he adds anything else. But I'm sure as hell not gonna put in that much garlic.
The music is mysterious and awesome.
That's Sim City for you.
You're missing out. Kimchi fried rice.
Kimchi fried. I've got a lot to learn about rice. Hell, I don't even have a decent rice cooker. I have a pressure cooker, and making shit in a pressure cooker is actually pretty fun.
Makes the whole thing more bearable.
Alright. So.
Cream of some young guy.
Not going there. Cut off and discard the root ends of the scallions. So we gotta check out the scallions. Hey, it has a little tear mark. Okay, another element that I've never messed with. So we'll do,
We too low.
Yeah, I knew you were going there. Holy fuck.
Holy fuck.
There it is. Alright. Fucking scallions. Thinly slice the scallion, separating the white bottoms and green tops. All right. I forgot to slice it up the middle first. Pretty well. Alright. Got some of the scallions. Mixing with everything else. Except for that one. Alright. What else? Speaking of which. Get that shit in there. I get all teary-eyed here.
Martha Stewart, tell us a story.
All right, what else? It's probably not enough scallions, but whatever. Slice of scallion, separating the white bottoms and green tops. In a bowl, combine... Okay. Let's do that now. In a huge-ass bowl... Combine combine the ponzu sauce, or is that shit, this stuff, the white bombs of the scallions, half of the sesame oil, 1 tablespoon of water, and as much sambal oelek. I'm not gonna wrap the catfish in bacon. That fish is definitely rotten. It's gotta dry out, okay? Can't have too much water on it. So it wants me to use all the ponzu sauce, huh? Or is it saying otherwise? 2 tablespoons. Does this look like 2 tablespoons? I'm gonna guess, follow the instructions on the other side. So that's the confusing part. That's the part where I'm like, do I put the whole thing in? Is that really 2 tablespoons? Because this says 2 tablespoons. I don't trust it.
One, 2 grams
each spoon. All right. Well, let's test the theory. 1 tablespoon. Yep, that was basically 1 table. It was basically 2 tablespoons. So they're right. Smells pretty good. Smells like the stuff I dip all my sushi in. All right, was it? White bottoms of the scallions. So all these. Half of the sesame oil. This stuff smells disgusting, by the way. So half of it, oh boy. Here comes disaster. All right, that's about half. Not like there's markings on it. Tablespoon of water.
Too much, not
too much,
like this.
Not like this.
Tap water, only the best. And as much as this bullshit as you want, depending on how spicy you'd like the dish to be. How spicy could it be? Oh, there it goes.
Something gotta burn down.
Oh hell. Let's put in the whole thing, huh? No, let's not put in the whole thing. Cause that does look spicy. Right, I don't want super spicy right now. All right. So, part two, finally, after, what is that, half an hour? All right, so the garlic rice, 1 teaspoon of olive oil, a medium high until hot. Why didn't it tell me to prep that before? Add the garlic, season with salt and pepper, and cook, stirring occasionally. All right, well, let's get a small thing here. Pots everywhere. All right. So let's get that one going. So this is a tablespoon. We need a teaspoon. Teaspoon. Did I put, so it says what, 1 teaspoon of olive oil? All right, let's, I've done this with garlic before. This is too big of a thing here, whoops. So 1 teaspoon of this shit. Put on medium heat. So until hot, then add garlic, salt, and pepper. Garlic, salt, and pepper. Sea salt. So cook, stirring occasionally, 1 to 2 minutes, or until fragrant. Then you're gonna add the rice, a pinch of salt. And 1.5 cups of water. And for this one, I'm definitely doing it with this actually. 1.5 cups. Close enough. It's getting hot yet. All right, let me move this over there because we're gonna focus on the garlic. So medium high. That's the worst part about cooking on flat tops. This takes forever to heat up. Absolutely forever. I think that's about 3 or 4. It's quite a few, actually. It's almost too much, really. But we'll see how it works out. gonna be extra garlicky. have to open up a freaking window after this one. You know what? Got a little bit more of this, get a few of these greens. So that's probably getting hot now. We need the rice. This is not one of those tear open ones, is it? Oh no, it is. Or at least it looks like it. Yeah, it's starting to get hot now. All right, so it's probably a little bit too hot. This is gonna get crazy. Let me open the window. All right. Should have put it in there before it got super hot. All right, so let's get that in there. Yeah, now it's oily, so.
Well, I'm off. Well, I'm off. Don't burn the house down.
Sure this shit doesn't burn. One to 2 minutes or until fragrant. Add the rice, a pinch of salt, and 1.5 cups of water. You got it. What are you facepalming? All right, I think that's... This is way too clumped. I think that's why they tell you to mince it. Let's get that in there. So, whoop. Rice. Really should put in the water and then the rice, but whatever.
Cat food.
There we go. It says a pinch of salt. It's about that. Heat to boiling on high. So we're gonna set it to high and see if that does the trick. Yeah, Sudi's off. Adios, if you haven't left already. Thanks for stopping by to see this disaster. All right, so what's the next step here while we're waiting for this to boil? You guys can see everything pretty well, by the way. Just kind of curious. So once boiling, cover and reduce the heat to low, and then cook for 12 to 14 minutes, or until the water has been absorbed and the rice is tender. Yeah, we'll see about that. Good thing I grabbed the pot that I have a top to this time. All right. Make the ginger peanuts. While the rice cooks in a medium pan, heat 1 teaspoon of olive oil on medium high until hot. Oh, here we go again. Boiling it. So I don't trust this pan. It's really scratched up is the problem. Is it boiling yet? Okay. So we'll get this on there. This is starting to boil. That, let's see, we got 14 minutes with that, right? Is that what it said? 12 to 14 minutes. So let's do 12 minutes. That looks like it's about boiling. So it says put the top on and do 14 or 12 on low. Cap it, put on low. Alexa, set a timer for 12 minutes. Okay, so we got 12 minutes going there. So while the rice cooks in a medium pan nonstick, 1 teaspoon of olive oil. Where'd I put it? God damn it. Down here. So 1 teaspoon.
Oh, it's Alexa.
Oh, it's Alexa, that's right. That was more than a teaspoon, by the way. Okay. Get this all heated up. So, heat 1 teaspoon of olive oil.
You're right.
On medium high. Add the peanuts and the ginger. I forgot to mince the ginger, by the way. So we better do that faster. Thank you. So I'd say this is pretty well minced. Okay. We'll grab another thing here before this starts getting super. Okay. Before that gets super hot, I meant to say. All right, good enough. Get this on standby. It wants that, peanuts and ginger. Season with salt and pepper, so more salt and pepper. So I'm sorry, I know I may have asked it before and I probably wasn't paying attention, but are the cameras doing all right? I mean, does it seem all right for this type of setup? It's not gonna be the best, but yeah, okay. How's the rice cooking? Who knows? It's cooking. I try to leave it alone. Ow! That's why. All right, this is starting to get kind of hot.
Cameras look good.
Cameras look good? Good. All right, so it says, add the peanuts and ginger, season with salt and pepper, cook, stirring occasionally, 1 to 2 minutes.
The rice is ready.
Or until lightly browned and fragrant. Browned and fragrant. 1 to 2 minutes. Transfer to a paper towel lined plate. Damn it. Good thing I paid attention here. Okay, so we'll do this. We'll grab another plate. Right here, how's that sound? You guys can see that. All right, so let's drop that in there. That looks pretty hot. The instructions do not go with cooking. To 2 minutes, so at 9:07 this will be done. It said to add some salt, right? Salt and pepper, season with salt and pepper. You got it. Smells interesting. I've never really cooked with ginger. Ever. Hence the, hey, you could peel it with a spoon. Who the hell would ever guess to cook something with a spoon? Or cook. Peel something with a spoon. So this says until golden brown. This will be the wipe down. The ginger, some of the ginger is starting to burn a little bit. So I think that is done. Okay, spread that out. It says to give this a wipe down. To try not to burn yourself. Kind of handy, right? Go. This to the side. Now, while the rice continues to cook in the same pan, heat 2 teaspoons of olive oil on medium high until hot again. So medium high on hot. Was it 2 teaspoons? Yeah. So I am going to check your question in a second, but I want to just make sure this is going to remain hot here. So this says, while the rice continues to cook, on the same pan, heat 2 teaspoons of olive oil on medium high until hot. So we gotta wait until hot. And this says, season to taste. I'm supposed to do that right as it comes out. Do you really scratch the pan about the hot plate? What? You're gonna have to rephrase that? It's not clicking with me right now. I'm not sure what you're asking. Add the zucchini in a single even layer. Season with salt and pepper. Cook for 2 to 3 on the first side or until browned. Flip. And then add the remaining sesame oil. Season with salt and pepper. 2 to 3 minutes. Transfer to a medium bowl and add all but a big pinch of sesame seeds. Okay, so it wants another goddamn bowl. Alright, well it's gonna get a small one. Actually, no, let's make it a big one. Let's make it a plastic one. All right. Alexa, time left.
About 1 minute and 50 seconds left.
1:50 left on that. So this is getting hot enough to start adding these, the zucchini. That's exactly what I'm gonna do. Two minutes on each side. Yeah, another one in there. I don't know. Did I? I don't think I did. I probably should have. Alright. So is this getting brown yet? I don't have one of those neat little tongs. Just have to use little pincers. So what else is missing here? Well, this is gonna be the glaze, I think. The thing we did in the bowl here, that's gonna be the glaze. The rice is almost done. There it is. All right. Alexa, cancel timer. All right, we're gonna start flipping these. And then I'm gonna tend to the rice. Alexa set a timer for 2 minutes. This is starting to brown. There we go. Hopefully it's not too much. All right, so this says remove from heat and fluff the cooked rice with a fork. All right. Go. Looks good to me. I would add butter to that, but whatever. That is done. Alright, so we're on this step. Cook 2 to 3 until browned and fragrant. Transfer to a medium bowl. Oh, it says add the remaining sesame oil. All right. Alexa, cancel timer. All right.
Yum.
Medium bowl. So let's flip. Make sure both sides are good. And we'll do the transfer. Kill the heat a little bit. This smells kind of good. There we go. Looks good. The bowl. Where's the bowl? It's right next to me. All right. So we'll put that out. Get this out of here. That. There we go. All right. Add all but a pinch, it says, of these sesame seeds, which is what I'll do, because it wants me to. I'll do it over here since you can't see, and I'm putting shit over there. All right, so we got this. All but a pinch. That's good enough by my standards. I don't particularly like sesame seeds. So I'm not gonna do all of them. All right. So now, toss the combine and season with salt and pepper to taste. Set aside in a warm place. Wipe out the pan again. Okay. Get this shit out again. Okay. Now, while the rice continues to cook, pat the catfish fillets dry with paper towels. I did that. Season with salt and pepper on both sides. Now, in that same pan, heat 2 teaspoons of olive oil again on medium high until hot. Add the seasoned fillets and cook for 4 to 6 on each, on the first side. Flip and then add the glaze. Cook, occasionally spooning the glaze over the fillets, 2 to 3 minutes or until thoroughly coated and cooked. All right, so back on it goes. Medium high heat. We're gonna put two more. Always takes a lot of freaking. That just needs one more now.
Can we see the fish up close?
You'll see it in the pan. All right, so we'll get that. What's there to? Like I said, these things don't. These cameras don't do so well up close, so there's not much I can do about that. I'm running around here. There they are. Okay, so this is in a...
Now we're talking,
now we're talking BB.
There we go. Here's the fillets. Can you get a good view? Some salt. Okay. Some pepper again. Not too much. They say to flip it. Some more. Probably a little bit too much. And what does it say? Once it's warm, put it on. All right. So it says, while the rice continues to cook, there I go again, season with salt and pepper on both sides. In the same pan, heat 2 teaspoons until hot. Add the seasoned fillets and cook for 4 to 6. So here goes. It looks pretty hot to me. This should have been a bigger pan, but let's try for the best here, huh? 4 to 6 minutes on the first side. Flip and then add the glaze. Maybe so, the here we go. Ready. Here comes the main course, right here. Alexa, set a timer for 5 minutes.
5 minutes.
30 minutes. All right, here we go. This is also my first time actually cooking catfish. I do a lot of tilapia. I love tilapia. And tilapia and salmon. Excellent, I love it. That stuff is easy to cook. Fish is pretty freaking easy to cook, but you still have to be careful. So if you could, set camera 1 Say it twice, so it points towards the table, I guess. Because we're done here, I think. Make sure something doesn't burn. Okay. Getting there. Cool. Thank you, John. Alright. So we'll pull a regular plate. Why not? Almost time to probably flip it. So, in the meantime, let's do this.
That transition looks cool, BTW.
Oh, I think my laptop went to sleep. That's not nice. Yep, it did. Oh well.
The dog voice might have died at Draco.
Okay. It's probably ready to flip. Alexa, time left.
About 2 minutes and 10 seconds left.
Wow, 2 minutes. So it looks like it's divide the garlic rice between two dishes, top the glazed catfish fillets, or top with it. So this is gonna go on there anyway, right? Get ready for my absolutely horrible plating skills here. I'm just gonna make a nice bed of rice for it to sit on here. Oh man, I can smell those peanuts or I can smell the garlic and everything else on this thing. Whoa! Off the plate it goes.
Oh my, that's a lot of rice.
There we go. Got ourselves a nice little bed of rice that's gonna overflow anyway. It's about time. Flip! Alexa, time left.
About 40 seconds left.
40 seconds. Get a nice tight shot of that, huh? The God voice died? Well, I'll check in a sec here. Alexa, cancel timer. I broke it. There we go. Now we put this on here. Oh yeah, look at that. Whew. That looks good. Smells interesting, that's for damn sure.
Fuck, that looks fucking delicious. Now.
Alexa, set a timer for 4 minutes.
4 minutes.
Alexa, cancel timer. Alexa, set a timer for 3 minutes. All right. Let that sit for a little bit. Let me check my battery pack. Test 1, 2, test 1, 2. Test 1, 2. Can you guys hear me? Test, test, test. Yep, you guys can hear me. Huh, weird.
Test, test, test.
Are you talking about the... I guess you're talking about the other thing. All right, this is almost ready, I think. Ow. There's like no more glaze left, so... Alexa, time left. A minute, 10 seconds, so I think we are ready. Like I said before, I don't want to overcook it, so. Or like you said before this. Put this over there. Trying to find my other spatula, but I can't find it. So we're gonna have to just use this one. But I think we're ready. That looks pretty good. Alexa, cancel timer. Supposedly you top it with this shit.
Oh my.
Spin the stove camera up if you want. Now it says to put the rest of the sesame seeds on it, but nah. There we have it. I guess that does it for the zucchini. There's only two more left. I think I'll leave that out. And there we go. I need a bigger plate. Shit. There's a bunch of these peanuts that are just gonna go flying all over the place. Here, whatever. Just. The peanuts go flying, they go flying, whatever. Okay, that's all off. There's a whole lot of cleanup to do, I'll tell you that much. Ah, there we go. All right. Let me grab one thing.
Link.
Put that right there. And there you have it. One interesting looking meal. Could really zoom in on it. There you go. So we'll do this. How about that? A little bit out more.
This turned out pretty damn good.
So, what I'll do is, I guess I'll keep this microphone on me, and I'll just point this at myself somehow. And I need to go put myself in social eating. It's the stupidest freaking thing in the world, but I gotta do it, right? How does it taste? I don't know. Do you see any food in my mouth? All right. Change this to social eating.
Indeed, OPER.
There we go. I am now in social eating, and it's kind of scary. By the way, hello, Night Code in Hitbox. I did take a peek over there. I'm not watching that chat. I'm actually chatting in Twitch. So if you say hello, I unfortunately not gonna see it. But yeah, let's eat before it gets cold. How about that? I'm waiting for it to cool down just a touch. But we're now social eating, boys.
Finally, stuff his mouth with food on Cam Kappa.
Social eating. Alright, let's grab a drink, some brown ale.
And it ain't donuts, Cap'n.
What'd you say? Yeah, this is Chew's fetish, didn't you know? I really need a bigger plate. Alright. Let's give it a shot. Some brown ale from the Newburgh Brewery in Newburgh, New York.
Looks pretty filling.
This is a meal for two. So yeah, it's gonna be overly filling. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to eat all of it. Unless I sit here for a while and, you know, chill. There we go. Boop. Actually, I'm gonna go in my room and raise the audio a little bit. Because I want to hear it. I haven't listened to the music at all for God knows how long. So let's give it a shot. Let's give our first cut now that it's probably getting cold here. This is as bright as it's gonna get. Actually, I lied. You know, we could do this. Come on.
We need that text to speech voice.
Come on, you're gonna let me? You're not gonna let me. Oh well, so much for that. That's all you're getting. That's all you're getting, guys. Should be bright enough. You need text-to-speech voice? No, you don't. that's why. That's why you didn't hear it. The laptop died. Laptop went into hibernate. All right, let's take a look here. Peanuts everywhere. Okay. Okay, that's the burnt part. oh, it's squeezing out.
Cause you gonna eat for two, you greedy fucker, Bible
thumb. Yep, eating for two. The rice. The rice tastes kind of peanutty. I'll show more of it if you're not seeing enough of it already. Once I clear the plate a little bit. Let's take a look at them. It's white, nice and fluffy. Not bad.
Let's see what's left on the counter.
Hmm. Not much. If anything, let's see. A small piece of zucchini. Maybe the last sixth of a zucchini. Not much of anything is left, really. There we go. Unfortunately, my camera, the little screen, doesn't rotate towards you, so I can't see how it's actually framing it. I have no idea. So welcome to social eating with Blue Apron. Getting a good shot of that.
Perfect.
Get the photos. Here. Let's get from this end. One more without the flash. Back to the Twitch channel. Oh, my phone's bugging out. All right. Reconnecting the chat. And we're back. Oh, man. 1 second.
Ain't that right?
One second. There you go.
Okay.
Yeah. Tastes pretty good. But you don't like fish, so. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Ginger. First time doing stuff with ginger. What? Finished? No. No. I'm eating. All right. Ain't that right? What'd you say? I didn't see what you said before. Ain't that right? Or whoever said anything there. So yeah, I mean, from a perspective of, I don't cook a lot, generally, but I have some basics. If you don't have basics, you might have some minor difficulty with this, or you might burn it to shit. So it's tough to say whether or not this meal is like
an immersive experience, all right, Kappa.
It's an immersive experience, yeah. I mean, outside of, you know, your typical, not necessarily showmanship, but just the matter of being, you know, chatting with you guys and not really necessarily 100% focusing on making it. It took longer than I thought.
Stick your entire face into the plate of food for full immersion, OP.
Yeah. Ah, there's the onion there.
Is it spicy?
No, actually it's not very spicy. I was expecting it to be a little bit more spicier, but not really tasting the spice. I think I probably could have made the rice a little bit better, but it's not bad either. I think overall, I could probably put more garlic into it. Give it a little bit more zing.
Wonder what else goes well with rice.
What doesn't go well with rice?
Oh, right, bacon. Kappa.
Oh. I see where you're going with that.
Speaking of which, might want to stick it back in the fridge.
Yeah, I'm gonna do that. It's sealed, so.
Unfortunately, backslash.
Yeah. Look, it didn't call for bacon, so I'm not gonna put bacon in it. I'm not sure, I'm not sure what to think of the peanuts. I don't like hard objects like peanuts in a dish like this. Because there's nothing to really bind outside of, you know, rice. There's nothing to really bind the peanuts to what you're eating. That, and I'm not too much of a peanut fan anyway. I'm not allergic to peanuts like every other wimp out there. That's right, I'm calling you guys out. You genetically messed up little crappers. Allergic to peanuts. Ugh. Nine people watching me eat, and only one person talking. Well, two if you count. If you count me.
Too busy drooling.
Too busy drooling. It does taste pretty good. Unfortunately, the peanuts are overpowering.
Apparently, like 70% of people in the world are allergic to milk.
That's an interesting statistic. The peanuts are overpowering the fish and the rice. So I may, like, avoid the peanuts now. And there we go. One fish down. Frankers.
She wants some fish too for dinner.
I think yeah, of course she does. Sorry about the chair, by the way. Brown ale is okay, but with fish, I'm thinking a crisper, like, Belgian, like a white ale, might go better with it. Hell, let's keep it simple. Just do a Budweiser. The zucchini tastes pretty fucking good. I will say that. This is really good stuff. Whoops.
How's it taste?
Hugs for reals. You know, I haven't had much catfish, but it tastes pretty good. It's actually not too bad. I probably could have put this in maybe for half a minute longer. This particular one, because this cut's pretty thick. But,
put that food down your anal hole, you dirty slut.
Oh, yeah. You keep talking dirty to me. It tastes pretty good. The glaze is not the best. You know, the glaze, they tell you to pour over this stupid
now
thing.
Now we are getting down and dirty capid.
But, it's very edible. To be quite honest, I was done after the first one. So from a perspective of that one filet, plus the rice and some of these zucchini slices, that's kind of okay. It's not that bad. Like, this is kind of going overkill now. Me trying to eat this is definitely gonna be overkill.
Then after you put it down, your anal shit it into my mouth, Duddy.
Wow. John.
Is that a beer?
Mm-hmm. It is. Newburgh Brown Ale.
Kinky. Fan sub sub.
I absolutely hate, I will say this right outright. For my many, many years of streaming, the one thing I typically don't do when I stream is eat.
Good stuff, Tom.
I don't eat at the same time that I stream. I always step away. But, hey, social eating, why the fuck not, right? Hi. But more importantly, I'm doing this Blue Apron stuff under my own will, of course. I'm not promoting them technically, and I'm not sponsored or any bullshit like that, but
how about we go full out and make it
this is my very first plate of actually trying to cook this stuff, and it was a little bit more complicated than I thought, at least for this dish. We'll see what the chicken one turns out to be, but whether or not it's worth the price, I don't know yet. I love this song. Making a mess of the table. Yes, I've messed with raspberry pies. I want to try an Arduino board. I'd like to give it a shot, but I need to get one. I don't really have any need yet. But, yeah, I've messed with the Raspberry Pi 1 and a 3. The latest one with Wi-Fi. And it's not bad, it just has lots of bugs.
Rura. Did you put the green onion on it, BT? Rura.
Mm-hmm. Yep, green onion went on it. Shit. Well, 8 second rule. We'll go at 8 seconds.
Which I guess is model A.
Hmm. There it is.
LMAO.
Yeah, I have the, I had the very first one, the Raspberry Pi 1.
That's quite a mess.
I haven't tried the 2. I hear the 2 is great, but it has some issues with the SD card slot. The spring-loaded SD card, was it micro SD in that one? Or was it just regular? No, I think it was just regular SD. But the push button, the spring, can break or fail, and then you have an SD card that's stuck in it. Or at least it's a pain in the ass to get out. I think that used to be an issue with two.
Micro.
It was micro.
Mine is anyway. What are we having for dessert, Duddy?
Oh, God. You know, that's the one thing they don't include. That is really the one thing they really don't include. That's Blue Apron. That is. They don't give you any desserts. That kind of sucks. You know what's for dessert? More beer.
Just
endless amounts. Endless amounts of beer. So how many of you have, browsed the various different channels in this section, in social eating? Have any of you done it? I've done it once, and was sorely disappointed. As you should be watching this, outside of this fish, of course.
I did it once.
You did it once!
This is my very first experience watching PPL eat. My thoughts exactly. Anyone wanna go on the deep web? Kappa.
Deep web. Oof. Yeah, I don't get it. 3D. You know, if I had either a bunch of GoPros or that 360-degree camera, I would definitely do this. Like, I would definitely set one up at a diner and do an Oculus Rift stream. That would be kind of fun. Or a Vive, or whatever. The sad part is, people would watch it. People would actually watch it. I do not get this section whatsoever. I am just like, why does this exist? It's a technical workaround for people who cook but can't eat it on stream. Yeah, that's kind of true. I guess that is kind of true. I don't care about the TOS, quite honestly, because it seems to be subjectively enforced, which is incredibly bullshit for a lot of reasons. You know, lots of broadcasters that pull in money get the go ahead or the okay, basically, to do whatever the hell they want. Up to a point, of course. But someone like me, you know, if I did one thing wrong, somebody does a stink, you know, kiss your ass goodbye. If you're not pulling in hundreds and hundreds of viewers, and you don't have, like, over, what, 50, 100 subscribers, your ass is grass. Yeah. Technically, you could stream 24/7.
Just kidding, don't do that.
You know, you could stream 24/7 with a fake plate of food in front of you and just talk to your audience. You don't even have to eat. You could just sit here in front of cold food the whole damn time. I don't know why you would, but Technically, that's okay. The problem is everybody looks... Everybody looks for... everybody worries about violating rules. Like, can I do this? What happens if I do that? Just stream. As long as you're not naked on camera and doing really bad things. Or playing porn. You kind of are fine. You know, you're not going to get banned. I mean, usually. You may have very bad luck and have some random person come in, like an admin, and all of a sudden say, oh, I don't like this stream, I'll shut you down, but... You know, next time, if there is a next time, if I make this particular dish, there's no way in hell I'm having the peanuts in it. The peanuts just, they don't do it for me. They really don't do it. I mean, I'm pretty sure it's the peanuts I'm tasting, too. It's just, meh. No. But then again, I'm eating two fillets, so... Maybe I'm overdoing it.
There better be a next time. This setup is way too fucking awesome to disassemble. Smiley yeah. Face.
Yeah, it's kind of pretty cool. I like the way the cameras work. I like the fact that people in chat can control the cameras. To an extent, of course. But really, it's... I set that up. The text commands. For me to interact from Alexa. I want voice commands from Alexa to be sent to the cameras so I can tell it where to go. So I don't have to adjust it. So, you know, if I say, well, that's the interesting thing. The sync thing may be unreproducible during later casts. There was something about these cameras that somehow worked. I don't know how they synced up, but they did. It's the weirdest thing. Like, it's matching up with my lapel mic, or it was at some point. It's matching up with the shotgun mic, which you hear over there, because I'm using a Sennheiser wireless mic right here. I'm sure you could see that in front of the food. So, that mic, and tons of other stuff, it was all in sync. I have no idea why there's no delay between OBS and the IP cameras. I just couldn't believe it. Absolutely couldn't believe it. Hello, Icy Fingers. I've had enough. That peanutty taste kind of killed it. So I'll mail the rest of this in a Ziploc bag over to Chew Toy. Unless Icy Fingers wants it, you can just drop your address and I'll mail it out to you, and you can get a really shitty half-eaten meal. Or, I'm sorry, it's not that bad. It would be if I put it in a Ziploc bag and mailed it to you, but there's nothing left over, though. There's, like, a little piece of fish here. A zucchini. Yeah, no. There's a bunch of rice, actually, left over. There's a bunch of rice left over here. I don't know if you guys can see it there. I mean, it's enough for maybe an extra plate. But blah. I should have put this in either a bigger plate or a dish. Or a bowl, I mean. Or something. Oh, man. Not bad for a first stream in a very long time, number one. I haven't streamed in like a month or two, almost. A month. After that wedding. After that wedding, it definitely took its toll, both before and after, to set up for it. I was basically a videographer at a wedding, a solo videographer. And that was interesting. Very, very stressful, interesting, and I'm out of shape, so that just really sucked. Did you rotate it around? Unfortunately, I don't have any commands to restart the bot from here.
You look like you lost quite a lot of weight, actually, and got a sunburn.
And got a sunburn? I don't know about that. Definitely no sunburn, surprisingly. I didn't feel any. hopefully I got a tan. I'm white as a ghost.
Yeah, wanted to see what's left on the counter.
Oh, right.
Nothing much.
Nope. It's all pretty much used up. Like I said, I still have two other meals. Waiting for me. Meals as in shipped from Blue Apron. Let me put the bacon back. You can rotate the camera into my fridge if you're fast enough. Fast. Oh, there you go. Close enough.
Over rotated it.
Where did the... Where'd the other ones go? Oh, there they are. So, so the two other meals are fresh basil fettuccine, which will be incredibly easy. And chicken and buttermilk biscuit sandwiches. So, both of these should be a lot easier to make. I honestly believe that the fish dish is probably one of the harder things to make. Because it's just the many different components, I think, in that one. I mean, you look at this one, and it was really the they call it the knickknacks, the extra shit that they throw in there. Again, if anyone's curious as to what the hell I'm talking about and what these are that I'm holding, this is the stuff that they send you. And they, you know, describe the meal, describe the ingredients and the knickknacks, the servings, and how fast you're supposed to be able to make it. And on the back, there's step-by-step instructions. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Only 6, of course. So they kind of cram all the instructions into 6 steps, which isn't that great. But I guess it gets the point across. If you look at some of the knickknacks on this one, it's like 2 tablespoons of butter, grated Parmesan cheese, 1 teaspoon of crushed red pepper flakes. That's it. And the other stuff, you know, had a lot more than that. Yeah, so. That recipe link will show you the 2 pages or 3 pages or 4 pages or however much it was of this one. But then I have folders underneath there which show off the fresh basil fettuccine and the chicken and buttermilk biscuit sandwiches. So it looks interesting. I can't wait to try it. I'm probably gonna have to do it either. Perfect. So I'll either do that, probably not tomorrow. Maybe I'll do it Monday night. Monday night I'll make the fettuccine or something. The chicken and buttermilk stuff, I don't know. I'd have to be pretty fucking hungry for that, so. We'll see. We'll see.